Praise the Lord. Shall we open our Bibles to John chapter 5, verse 1 to 9? We've looked at part 1, part 2. Today we are looking at part 3 of the law of timing in relation to our miracles. In relation to our miracles. John chapter 5, verse 1 to 9. John chapter 5, verse 1 to 9. So I read. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches or porticos. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the waters. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie, and he knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he saith unto him, Wilt thou be made whole? Wilt thou be made whole? The impotent man answered Jesus, Sir, I have no man, when the water is troubled, to put me into the pool. But while I am coming, another stepped down before me. Jesus said unto him, Rise up, take up thy bed, and walk. Verse 9. And immediately the man was made whole, and took up his bed, and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath day. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless his word that we have read. And we've been looking at John chapter 5 from when we started talking about the law of timing in relation to our miracle. Today we are looking at part 3. We're looking at part 3 of the message. So number 5. Part 3, number 5. We look at 4b. Verses 4b of the text we have read. And the principle is that miracles are a reward to those who act with the sense of urgency. Miracles are a reward to those who act with a sense of urgency. The Bible says that there went down an angel, but there must also be those who enter in. An angel will come down and come and stir the waters, but there's an expectation of men or people who must go into the waters that the angels have come to stir or troubled. So very important. The principle that works here is what we call first in, miracle out. I call it FIMO. First in, miracle out. We have a principle called FIFO and LIFO. FIFO means first in, first out. LIFO means life in, first out. We sometimes can have LILO, last in, last out. So it become LILO or LILO. But this principle is FIMO or FIMO, which is first in, miracle out. The Bible says anytime this angel will come and stir the water at a specific time, whoever entered into the stirred water first. So it is like a one miracle at a time project. Whoever entered first will end up receiving the miracle. What the Bible says that whoever, so there was no name, no specific thing said, but just that whoever entered. This gives us a principle that miracles become a reward even to those who act with a sense of urgency. We must come to the place where we do things with a sense of urgency, where in our own miracles we'll expect God, even with that sense of urgency, where we will act with that sense of urgency, where we will not postpone or push aside, where we will not even try even to defer things, but as they come to us, we take them and we exercise what we need to exercise for the miracles to happen. Hallelujah. May the Lord reward you for acting with a sense of urgency in the presence of your miracle, in the presence of God's divine intervention, that you have that urgency. You have that urgency you are operating with, and may God reward your sense of urgency with a miracle. Number six, we'll find in verses 5 to 7. The number six principle, find in verses 5 to 7. Miracles are made easy when Christ becomes our Kairos. Miracles are made easy when Christ becomes our Kairos. The Bible made it clear that this young man has been there for a long time. In fact, he was 38 years. For somebody's age to be known like that, for somebody to be there for a long time like that, it means people really know him. Because people come and they go. Yet this man will sit at the pool waiting for a miracle to occur. For a miracle to occur. Miracles are in the realm of divinity and not in the realm of humanity. When Jesus asked him, "Why have you been here for long? Why have you to receive a miracle?" What the man said was that, he said, "For I had no man to help me. For any time I try any initiative for my miracle, somebody else with speed go ahead of me and drops into the water. Somebody ahead of me, somebody will just go ahead of me and take my miracle." So every time his miracle was being taken, even though he made the effort, but his effort was not enough for him to procure a miracle. As a result of that, Jesus Christ had to descend to the place to become the time for the man. So that's why the principle that miracles are made easy when Christ becomes our Kairos time, when Christ becomes our specific time, when Christ becomes our director time, when Christ becomes the focus of our time, the miracles will be made easy. How do I know that Christ can become our time, or Christ is our time? Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 and 7. "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. His name shall be called even Emmanuel. His name shall be called Wonderful. His name shall be called even with all the names that were given." One of the names that were given him is that he's the Father of eternity. He's the Father of time. That makes God time. Because if I'm a father of something, then that thing becomes me and I become that thing. Because my DNA will be that thing, and that thing draws the DNA from me. So God is time. Jesus is our time. I don't know how you see yourself and what you are going through. You may think your time is past. You may think you have wasted time in life. But when Christ becomes our Kairos time, the miracles will be made easy. It doesn't matter the time you have wasted. It doesn't matter the time that is past. Christ, being the Father of time, knows how to take time, knows how to manipulate time, knows how to work time, and knows how things work with time. Miracles require human effort, but divinity is the one who releases the miracle. "But while I am coming, another go ahead of me." Inasmuch as our human effort, our faith, and all that is required of us must be brought to bear and put in place, we must understand that your miracle is not because of your effort. Your miracle is released by God himself. He releases it, but we got to relate to his release so that we can receive our miracle. We need to understand that miracles requires human effort, but divinity is the one who releases the miracle. I want you to know that God is your time. And God is the source of your miracle, and he'll release it at the appropriate time. Finally, verses 8, which is number 7 principle. verses 8. Miracle time or timetable are revised by the Lord God of time. The miracle timetable, the miracle time can be revised even by the God in charge of time. And that's what Jesus did. Even though the principle at Bethesda, the pool, the water place, is that an angel must come and stir the water. God arranged it. And whoever entered first, things begin to happen. But Jesus saw that a man needed his own special, specific miracle. So Jesus broke the protocol. And he came there by himself to the spot. Even though an angel was doing the job on their behalf, on the behalf of God the Father, on behalf of God the Son, on behalf of God the Spirit, this time, God the Son, Jesus, had to show up in a place. Why? Because he wanted to revise the timetable. He wanted to change the timetable in order for somebody's miracle to happen. The Bible says in the book of Peter, that 1,000 years is like a day before God, and a day is like 1,000 before God. I see this God as a God who has the power, who has the grace, who has ability, who has the soul mandate, who has the capacity, the capability, even to manipulate time for the purposes of a miracle to happen, for his glory to be seen. Let me repeat it. God is the one that can manipulate time in order to bring interventions so that his glory shall be seen or be laid bare or be brought bare. Is a God of miracles indeed. Daniel chapter 2 verses 20 to 22. When Daniel and his friends are prayed, and God has shown them the vision of Nebuchadnezzar and given them interpretation, when they were brought before Nebuchadnezzar, one of the things Daniel said, that the God who revealed the vision and gave the interpretation is a God who has the power to change times and season. I see the Lord changing your time and your season in order to fit a miracle into your life, or bring you to fit into the scheme of his miraculous calendar. Jesus changed the timetable. He changed the order. He changed the arrangement. He changed the agenda. He said, everybody will receive a miracle by the angel stirring the water. But for this particular one, I have come myself in order to give him his miracle, because he needed that intervention. When we make Christ our time, our Kairos, then he will be able to change the timetable and revise them. Maybe you think you are very old, like Abraham, like Mama Sarah, but God took their time and revised it. You think you are old, like Zechariah and Elizabeth, but God took time and revised it. So God is always revising time. You may think your age is advancing. You are aging forward. God can actually cause you to age backwards. He is God and he can do anything. One time I was praying and the Lord said to me, he said, my son, I will halve your years. I will divide your years into two. In other words, when you are 20, you'll be 10 years. When you are 30, you'll be 15 years. When you are 40, I'll make you 20 years. God is a God who can make that happen. In conclusion, most of us may have lost our time in our season of the miraculous or a miraculous visitation. But Christ, our miracle, always presents us with another miracle opportunity. Let me repeat that. Most of us may have missed or might have missed our miraculous visitations. But I want us to understand that Jesus Christ, our miracle, will always present us with another mini miracle opportunity. Maybe you missed a miracle, but I want you to understand that Jesus is here to give you another opportunity for you to embrace a miracle in a special way. May God bless his word, and may God even change the timetable regarding your miracle so that he can bring you back on course and fix a miracle for you. May God himself, who is the God of time, who father time, take time and revise everything for your sake. May God bless you as I come to you again the next time with a message on the issues of miracle. God bless you, and I love you. Amen.